Good evening. We'd like to welcome you to the Trinity Baptist Church in Westfield, North Carolina. Our church is located at 1233 Collinstown Road, Westfield, North Carolina. And our services on Sunday mornings are at 10 o'clock. We have Sunday school preaching at 11, Sunday nights at 6 o'clock p.m. We're having in-person services, and then also we have an FM transmitter for those that would like to come to the parking lot and listen on the FM radio. They can do that as well. They can tune to 92.9 in our parking lot. But this is our Wednesday night services. We normally have Wednesday night services at the church, but temporarily we're not able to do that. I'm not able to do that. I'm having to be with my dad and stay with my dad right now while my mom is recovering from a broken leg. So we're doing our Wednesday night services like this for a little while. And hopefully it won't be very long, but we're going to try to do this on Wednesday nights for a while. Hope it'll be a blessing to you. And at least we can, our folk and anybody else can watch this on YouTube or their Trinity Baptist Church Westfield Facebook page or my page. My name's Tommy Nichols, my Facebook page. It'll be on there at 7 o'clock on Wednesday nights. And I thank you for viewing. And what we're going to do is we're going to start a study on the book of James and just try to do this on Wednesday nights for a while temporarily. Hope you'll be opening up that good old authorized King James Bible and turn with us to the book of James chapter number 1. James chapter number 1. I love this book. It's a great book of the Bible. They all are. I love this book. It's special to me. And I hope it'll be a blessing to each and every one of you tonight as we just have a short Bible study tonight. We're not going to be real long or anything like that, but I want to share a few things with you from the Word of God. First thing I'd like to do is I want to go to the Lord in prayer, trying to do this kind of like we do our Wednesday night services. And we've got a lot of folk on our prayer list from the church that need prayer, and we're praying for them and then others as well. And let's remember these folks that are sick, these that are shut in nursing homes, rest homes, hospitals, maybe in their own home. Let's remember them in our prayers. And also let's pray for our country. Let's pray for those in authority over us, that God would deal with their heart. Let's pray for their salvation if they don't know Jesus as their Savior. Let's pray they'll get right with God. Amen. I know the Lord's able to do that. So you pray with us. We want to go to the Lord in prayer. We'll be looking in the Word of God here in just a few minutes. But let's pray together and pray with us and pray for us, if you would. Pray for the lost, most of all. They'll get saved. Those that's backslid, they'll confess their sin, get right with the Lord. And let's just pray for one another and other services that are going on tonight as well. Father, we do thank you for the privilege of doing this, our very first time doing this for a Wednesday night service. We miss being able to gather there with the church at the building on Wednesday nights, but I'm glad that we can do this on Wednesday nights. At least we can view or watch this and get in on it and just have a time together with our church folk through this video. I pray it be a blessing. I pray for those in authority over us for their salvation. I pray for those that's sick. I pray for those that are shut in. God, that you'd bless them in a great way. God, I just pray for our country, and I pray you'd help us right now as we have this service, and we'll praise you and thank you for all you do for us. In Jesus' precious holy name we pray, amen. Now, I think since this is a Wednesday night service, I think we'll sing a song, and you can sing along with us there wherever you're at. And this one just comes to mind. I'm not really still trying to figure out how we're going to do this, but anyway, we'll try to sing a song here, and I hope it'll be a blessing to you. And every one of you will know it. It's in the old Redback church hymnal. Gonna sing page 87. And we won't have any music tonight. We're just going to sing it without music. But I hope it'll be a blessing to you tonight. We'll do a little bit of this, and then we'll get right on into the book of James, chapter number 1. If you know this, you sing along. And thank God this song is so, so true. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, he who died, heaven's gates to open wide. He will wash away my sin. Let his little child come in. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me still, though I'm very weak and ill. From his shining throne on high comes to watch me where I lie. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Aren't you glad Jesus loves us? I'm so glad he loves me. Let me try one more for you here tonight. And like I said, this is not going to be a long video, but we'll try one more for you tonight. And I hope this will be a blessing to your heart. We usually do this one without music, so we'll see if we can remember the words. I sure do hope we can. I was standing on the bank of the river, looking out over life's troubled sea, when I saw an old ship that was sailing. Is that the old ship of Zion I see? Its hull was bent and battered. From the storms of life I could see. The waves were rough, but that old ship was sailing. Is that the old ship of Zion I see? At the stern of the ship was the captain. I could hear as he called out my name. Get on board, it's the old ship of Zion. It will never pass this way again. And as I step on board, I'll be leaving all my troubles and trials behind. I'll be safe with Jesus the captain, sailing out on the old ship of Zion, sailing out on the old ship of Zion. The old ship of Zion. Hope that was a blessing to you this evening. Well, we're going to look in that good old authorized King James Bible to the book of James, chapter number 1. I love the book of James, and we're just going to try to do this for a little while. At least while we're not able to have Wednesday night services there at the church building. So I hope you'll plan on viewing on Wednesday nights or any time after that. Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock. We'll try to do this, as I said, on our Facebook page, our church Facebook page, Trinity Baptist Church Westfield, or Tommy Nichols, my Facebook page, or on my YouTube page, which is Tommy Nichols, and you'll find that as well. If you do a search on YouTube, there's past videos where we do 10 minutes with the pastor. There's past songs, but we just want to share this with you tonight, and I hope this will be a blessing to you. James chapter number 1. The Bible says in verse 1, James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting. James is writing to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad. He's speaking of those born again Jewish believers that were scattered during the persecution of the church we read about in the book of Acts. Well, the Bible says James was a servant of God. I've heard this, I don't know this for a fact, I read this, that he was referred to as old camel knees. He spent a lot of time on his knees. We've also been taught that this was the half-brother of the Lord Jesus Christ, probably the half-brother. Jude probably was as well. But regardless, James, he writes a letter because he's concerned about people. He wants them to be strong in the Lord. He wants them to live for God. So he writes a letter, and he says, first of all, James, who is the writer, he says, a servant of God. Well, thank God for people that'll be servants of God. Serve the Lord. And you know, that's what God wants every one of us that are born again to do, is to serve the Lord. Amen. Psalms 100 says, well, to serve the Lord with gladness. Amen. Serve Him with gladness. I'm not talking about sadness or madness. I'm talking about we ought to serve the Lord with gladness. Whatever we do for God, whether it's what I'm doing right now or whatever you do, listen, for the Lord, we ought to do it with gladness. We ought to be glad to do it. I've said it many times. Preachers ought to be glad to preach. Amen. Singers ought to be glad to sing. Deacons ought to be glad to deek. Amen. Sunday school teachers ought to be glad to teach Sunday school. Born again saints, listen. Hey, anybody that's born again, whatever we're doing, we should do it with gladness. And James writes this letter, I don't think in boasting, but I think he writes this letter to let them know that he was a servant of God. He wasn't a servant of self. He wasn't a servant of some other man, but he was a servant of God. And I believe that's what God wants us to be, his servant. He goes on to say he's a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. Notice he said the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is Lord. He is the Messiah. He is the Savior, thank God. And boy, I'm glad that He is. So Jesus Christ, He says, I'm a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. So He said, I'm also a servant of Jesus Christ. Then He tells us who He's writing to the 12 tribes. He says, which are scattered abroad. He says, greeting. He says, hello. I've got some good news for you. I've got something that'll help you. Now, you got to remember, these people were scattered from Jerusalem because of persecution against the church. They were scattered abroad. And the Bible says they went everywhere. But as they went everywhere, the gospel was being spread. And James is wanting to encourage these folks. He says in verse 2, now this may sound strange, but this is right. James says in James chapter 1, verse number 2, he says, my brethren. We know he's writing to the brethren. So he's writing to saved, born again, Jewish believers. But I believe this book can apply to any of us that are born again believers. He says, my brethren, now listen to this, count it all joy when ye fall into divers temptations or different temptations. Now, what he's saying is this, count it all joy when you go through trials, when you go through temptations, when you go through troubles, count it joy. In other words, rejoice. Now that's the opposite of what we do most of the time. We usually don't count it all joy, do we? No. We have a pity party. We feel sorry for ourselves, you know, various other things that we can go through. But James said when we're going through trials, hey, I'm going through one right now. But I'm telling you, the Bible tells me that I ought to count it all joy. You know, I love Romans chapter 8, verse number 28. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to His purpose. Man, I got to remember that. All things are working together for good. Our lives change. Listen, things change in our lives. Nothing stays the same, seems like. As we age, things change. Things, you know, we have to face different things that we have to face. And we have to maybe do things different. But he says we should count it all joy, thank God, when you fall into diverse temptations. Now, or different temptations. Now, why should we count it all joy? Why should we count it all joy? He goes on to tell us in these next few verses. He says, knowing this, he says, we should count it all joy. Listen, when we fall into divers temptations, brethren, because we can know something. Knowing this, and he goes on to talk about that. Listen, the reason we can count it all joy when we fall into divers temptations is because we know that it's going to help us. It's going to help us. You know, I heard this said a while back. It was said, when we go through trials, they can make us bitter or they can make us better. And that is a fact. I've seen that ever since I heard that. You know, trials that we go through, they can make us bitter. They can make us better. I've learned that I've got a lot of growing I need to do with the Lord. I need to get closer to the Lord. And sometimes, you know, this old flesh wants to get controlled on it. But we've got to put God first. So he says, when we go through things, know this. Now, it don't say, well, hope this. No, it says knowing this, that the trying of your faith or the testing of your faith is going to produce something. It's going to work something. What's it going to work? Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. It worketh patience. It gives us patience. I guarantee you that's an attribute that every one of us need more of, is patience. Think about this. He says in verse 4, but let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing or lacking nothing. So he says in verse 3, knowing this. Brethren, when you're going through something, know this, that the trying of your or my faith is working something in our lives. It's doing something good in our lives, thank God. It's working patience, thank God. And he says this, but let patience have a perfect work. In other words, it'll mature us. It'll make us a more mature Christian. But let patience have a perfect work. Why? That ye may be perfect. And that means mature, by the way, a mature Christian. That ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing or lacking nothing. So I'm going to close with that verse this evening, on this Wednesday evening, but I want us to think about that. Brethren, count it all joy, verse 2 said, when you fall into divers temptations, knowing this, that the trying of our faith, or your faith worketh patience, but let patience have her perfect work. Amen. Why? That you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. Boy, God's good to us. God's good to us. James said he was a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, help me. That's my desire. Is that your desire? That's my desire. Well, I want to learn to count it all joy when I'm going through things, because I can know that it's working patience in my life. I can know that if patience has her perfect work in my life, I'll be mature. I'll be perfect or mature in the Lord is what that means. And entire, wanting or lacking nothing. I'll close with this. I wrote this down. I don't remember where I read it at, but I wrote this down many years ago, and I'll read it to you today or to this evening, and I hope it'll be a blessing to you. Listen to this. We may not have control over our circumstances, but we need to control our attitude in the Lord. Amen. Think about that. Let me read it again. We may not have control over our circumstances, but we need to control our attitude in the Lord. And we can do that with the Lord's help. Here's something else I wrote down. Patience is a fruit of the Spirit. And it is. If we're going to be Spirit-led, Spirit-filled, then that's going to be something in our lives. My dad said something to me the other morning. I believe it was a morning, or it might have been an evening. I don't know, as I was sitting there on the bed giving him his medicine and doing some things. And my dad said something to me that he said, son, you sure are patient. Now, I didn't say that to brag on me. Hear me out. Son, you sure are patient. I sat there and I thought about what he said. And here's what I thought about. God knows I need a whole lot more. Amen. God knows I need a whole lot more. But you know what? He's going to give it to me. Amen. Let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing or lacking nothing. Listen, I may not have control. You may not have control over your circumstances, but praise God, with the help of the Lord, we need to control our attitude, don't we? I'm going to close. I hope this has been a help to you. We'll try to keep these to around 20 minutes so it'll be easier for people to view and watch. It won't take a huge chunk of time. But this is the way we're going to be doing our Wednesday night services for a while. We'll be doing them here. And I hope you'll tune in on, like I said, Trinity Baptist Church Westfield Facebook page, or Tommy Nichols, our Facebook page, or on YouTube, either one. Tommy Nichols, I have a YouTube page, and I've got preaching and singing on it. But it'll be on. We'll try to put it on Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock. We'll try to get it on right at 7 o'clock on Wednesday nights. And we hope and pray that it will be a help to you. Let's close in prayer. Father, thank you for this time we've had with these folk. And I pray that the Word of God has been an encouragement and a help to them. Because that's what I know you want it to be. That's what I want it to be. And Lord, I pray for that lost sinner in ear's tail, that they'll get saved, that they'll repent of their sins and call on the Lord before it's too late. And Lord, that backslid brother or sister in Christ, that they'll get right with you, confess their sin, get right with you. Lord, I'm glad you tell us if we confess our sins, you're faithful and just to forgive us our sin and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Thank you for the Word of God. Bless these folks for viewing. And I pray we'll all be more mature in the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for viewing this evening. I hope this has been a blessing to your heart. Lord willing, we'll be back next Wednesday evening right here. And I hope it'll be a blessing to your heart as well. God bless you is my prayer.